Well, my goodness gracious, let me tell you the news. My head's been wet with the midnight dew. I've been down on bended knee, talking to the man from Galilee. He spoke to me with a voice so sweet, I thought I heard the shuffle of angels sweet. He called my name and my heart stood still when he said, John, go do my will. Go tell that long-tongued liar, go and tell that midnight rider, tell the rambler, the gambler, the backbiter, tell him that God's gonna cut him down, tell him that God's gonna cut him down. You can run on for a long time, run on for a long time, run on for a long time. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down, sooner or later, gotta cut you down. Well, you may throw your rock, hide your hand, working in the dark against your fellow man. But as sure as God made black and white, what's done in the dark will be brought to the light. You can run on for a long time, run on for a long time, run on for a long time. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down, sooner or later, gotta cut you down. Go tell that long-tongued liar, go and tell that midnight rider, tell the rambler, the gambler, the backbiter, tell him that God's gonna cut you down, tell him that God's gonna cut you down, tell him that God's gonna cut you down.
Oh, you big disgrace, kicking your can all over the place, singing,
we will rock you. We will rock you.
Buddy, you're a young man, hard man, shouting in the street, you're gonna take on the world someday, you got blood on your face, a big disgrace, waving your banner all over the place. Somebody better put your bag into your place.
We will rock you.
Sing it.
We will rock you.
Everybody,
we will rock you.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, Caravan fans, welcome back to the Alumni Gym here at Mount Carmel High School. Tonight, 26 students, from the smallest freshmen to the biggest seniors, will show off their boxing skills in the ring for MC's 46th annual Fight Night. My name is Matt Malloy, and I will be your play-by-play announcer. For the next 13 bouts, I will be joined alongside your color commentator and my cousin, Marty Mann.
Thank you, Matt. Yes, you fans are truly in for a treat tonight. Personally, I'm really, really looking forward to these fights, and I have been for a long time now. And I just really think it's great that even students like under 140 pounds are able to compete in this big of an atmosphere tonight alongside heavyweights over 250 pounds.
You know, Marty, I'm really excited as well. Marty, what fights are you most looking forward to tonight?
All right, Matt. So tonight I have three fights that are standing out to me. So the first one is our 170 bout, which is featuring Tim McInerney, a sophomore, who will be going up against Emmett Winters, another sophomore. So Tim, he fought last year and beat Leonard Siegel, another sophomore, last year for his first bout. And Emmett Winters, this is his first year, so he's looking up to show the crowd who he is.
Yep.
But just because it's his first does not mean he won't be ready.
For sure.
Trust me, these guys are pretty tough kids.
Yep, we have a lot of sophomores competing this year in the ring. It's going to be very interesting to see two of them go at it.
And our second bout that we're looking forward to is another sophomore, Matt Muha, who many of you guys might know from his football season on the JV and even the varsity roster during the playoffs. He will be going up against another football player, Vinny Winters, a junior. Now, Matt lost last year against a senior, I believe. And Vinny, I'm pretty sure it's his first year fighting on Fight Night. So, but once again, Vinny, like his brother Emmett, these kids are tough kids and are going to make this crowd very excited and put on a true show.
For sure.
And my final fight that I have checked off here
I've been a throw up the sex in a and I can put you in. City from this balcony. Back in 2019, I was outside freely, but now they got it out for me. I don't care what frat that you was in, you can't out for me. Keep dreaming. Pineapple juice, I give a sweet, sweet, sweet semen. I know what they like, so I just keep cheesing. Hard drive full of heat seeking. Tryna come the same day as Jack rethinking. You don't need Givenchy, you need Jesus. Why do y'all sleep on me? I need your reasons. I got plaques in the mail peak season. Shout out to my UPS workers making sure I receive it. You could do it too, believe it. I've been a throw up the sex in a and I can put you in.
Are you ready? Are you ready?
Yes, I am. They say you a superstar, now damn, I guess I am. You might be the man, well that's unless I am. Okay, I'll confess I am. Go ahead and get undressed, I am. Okay, cool, you on Sunset?
I am.
I'm about to slide, okay, I'm outside, okay. This lifestyle don't got many downsides. Except for the lack of time, I get around my family, making sure they never downsize. I got visions of my mom saying, wait, this house is mine. Can't lie, I'm on Angus Cloud 9. I got him on a bandwagon now, about time. I ain't even got no downtime. Every time I speak, she say, yeah, that sounds fine. I've been a throw up the sex in a and I can put you in.
Hello, everybody. Mount Carmel High School. Wow, 2023. 46 years and still rolling. Thank you. Such a big crowd tonight. We're so appreciative of that. Thank you to all the mothers and fathers of the men that are participating. Be sure to enjoy the food and beverages and buy your raffle tickets when you get a chance. We have split the pot raffle tickets and so on. I'm losing my voice already. So much to do tonight, so much to talk about. We have 13 championship bouts. Wow, are you going to see some good bouts tonight? But remember, these are all Mount Carmel students. They're in the same classrooms. They know each other. They're friends. So no matter how it turns out, let's be sure and give all of them a nice round of applause. President, this is a Father's Club production. We've been doing this for so many years now, and it's getting better and better all along. The man that's made it better from the very beginning is Jack Riffis. He's been fantastic. We got together so many years ago and we were determined to take it from an afternoon show to an evening show and make it certainly the talk of the town. Mount Carmel Fight Night. President this year is Tom Osselborn. Chairman, the man with the money, is Paul Rowan. He's been doing it for 17 years and still going. All the workers you see here tonight with the beer, with the tickets, out in the parking lot, these are all Father's Club members and alumni dads. Without them, we could not do this. All the work it took, and of course, we wouldn't be able to do this as easily without our sponsors. Thank you. Our sponsors are sitting all here at ringside, and I hope to get a chance to acknowledge every single one of you, depending on how the night goes. But thank you, thank you, thank you to our sponsors. So many of the young men tonight, you will find, with a crowd like this, where will you go anywhere and find? Good, Father. Where will you find? This is like Las Vegas. It's just like Las Vegas. This first time in the ring, they're very nervous, and we're so happy. We have some great, great coaches. This is intramural boxing. So, let's get started with tonight's show. I'm supposed to announce the referee first. Where the hell is he? The referee's not even here tonight. Okay, the man, the most important man in the ring. He's a cosmic professional. He does it all over the state. His name is David Hernandez. The judges, like Mount Carmel does it so differently than many, many schools or clubs. No one involved in Mount Carmel, no one's Father's Club. We have the real, real deal when we have judges. We have Bernard O'Shea. We have Linda Engel. And we have Danny Kosis. All of them are professionals in their own thing. The doctor tonight, we're really appreciative that the doctor is here tonight, Dr. Shuford. Thank you very much, Dr. Shuford. And the head coaches who've been working with these guys, training with them. I just got into town a week ago because this fight was supposed to be a week later. So I just got into town. I am so happy to be back in Chicago. I'm so happy to get out of that nice weather in Florida and come to Chicago. Here we go. Head coach and alumni, Mikey Davis. Where's Mikey Davis? An alumni coach with his own gym on the south side that most of these guys train in. The wonderful, great trainer, Danny Letts. And doing some of the training, he's not here tonight, is Marty Jakubowski, the Indiana Terror. Assisting the coaches, Mr. John Kapp, Leo Ere, and Rocco Magero. At ringside is our principal, Brendan Conroy, is here somewhere, but he didn't have a seat. How could we not have a seat for the president of Mount Carmel? So he's here somewhere, Brendan. I'd like to also introduce you to our ring assistant, Louis Cepetto. Come on in, Louis. Louis Cepetto's on that football team. How about that great football team this year, huh? I'll tell you one thing, I'll never forget the Loyola game or the last game, the Batavia game. I was so happy in that Batavia game. So, Louis, you know, Louis, that reminds me. Louis Cepetto is the kicker on the varsity team. We have a celebrity who was a kicker on the Mount Carmel's team. Let me tell you, where's Zachariah? Where is he? Here he is, Zachariah Mirabelli. All you girls, get a good look at him. He's the number one, or the top model in New York City. And imagine, people pay money to take pictures of him. Zachariah Mirabelli. Okay, Dan LeCount is on music. Thank you. Don Bundy's on sound. And the two guys that are fantastic under DeFilippo are Jack Brickley and Matt Malloy and Marty Mann. Whoa, the man of the hour. We're going to honor the man of the hour here in a minute, because we have something else going. For the prayer, we have Father Trace O'Sullivan. Please, if you can, stand for Our Lady of Mount Carmel. Listen up. Father Trace, his prayer.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Gracious God, we thank you for this gathering this evening. We thank you for the gift of courage and commitment of these young men. We thank you for the blessing of such a positive expression of competition in a world ravaged with every level and manner of violence. We ask your blessing on this community, and most especially for the safety of these young men. As always, we pray this in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Now, if you wish, please stand. We're going to have our national anthem by a Mount Carmel student, Gabe DeValle. What we're going to do first is, before we get to the national anthem, he's going to sing a song that's warm to all of our hearts. If you know the song, you should join in. Sing along. Make sure the world hears you. The first of two songs. Here we go. Gabe DeValle.
God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above. From the mountain to the prairies to the ocean, white with foam. God bless America, my home, sweet home. God bless America, my home, sweet home. Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Gabe DeValle. Thank you, Gabe. Are you ready for some boxing? The signature show, Mount Carmel High School. What pipes? Okay, we're going to have a little bit more. I didn't realize this. We got a little entertainment coming in. Is that correct? Let's hear from our famous bagpipe group. They're going to circle the ring. Please be our guests. How about that? Chicago Police Department bagpipes. Fantastic. I just found out about it. Okay, I'm glad to see that. Now, before we start the evening, this is a little workable announcement. We want no visitors and no parents. Nobody that doesn't belong in the red corner or the blue corner. We don't need any more people there than the coaches and the boxers. So please, even if your boy is getting in the ring, leave it alone. Everybody will be okay. Okay, I guess we're ready. Are you ready? Boxers, enter the ring.
Well, Marty, with an introduction like that, it's bound to be a fantastic fight night here at Mount Carmel. Right now, though, for the first bout, we've got the 150-pound class.
Okay, here we have...
and a junior.
At 150 pounds, out of the red corner, he's a sophomore. His name is Aiden Carrera. And out of the blue corner at 150 pounds, he's a junior. He weighs in at 150 pounds, and his name is Evan Wersma.
All right, here we go, Matt. And Caravan fans, I would like to repeat what has just been said. In the red corner, we have Aiden Correa. And in the blue corner, we have Evan Wiersma. Here we go.
A wonderful start here, a great introduction. Their tanks are full, but they're wasting a lot of energy right here. You know, you get to those later rounds, they might be a little tired. They're ready to go, though. I mean, months of training has gone into this.
Months.
They want to show what they're capable of. They want to show the amount of work they've put off. You see Wiersma, he's getting hot there. Yep. Bouncing around in the corner, he's ready to go. This sophomore-junior matchup, they both got some history with boxing. Correa lost, yes, last year, excuse me, looking to get some revenge. But right now, Wiersma's got the upper hand in this fight. That left jab is crucial. Puts Correa in a corner there. Correa able to push him off. They meet at the center of the ring. And as you can see, they're tired already. I mean, Wiersma's head is falling a bit. Correa taking a lot of jabs to the head there. Wiersma's still going at him. A big hit. Looked like it almost went to the back of the head there. I think he's all right, though. Still standing up.
A lot of punches and jabs. Seem very weak, not really taking the time, kind of just going after it. But it's an approach that they both share. Oh.
Burning off some energy. I think Wiersma got a jab after the bell there. I mean, that was a really good first round to start it off here, as you can see, I believe.
Pretty wild first round.
Yep.
I mean, it was almost like a little girl fight, just back and forth in the arms, but I'm sure they know what to do now.
I think they just, that was all nerves. That was all part of the mental game. There are hundreds of people here that's streaming online. We almost have 200 people watching right now. They know the amount of stress that they're going to have to take leading up to this. And I think they just wanted to get set. They wanted to take some punches, and they also wanted to throw some, obviously, right there. So,
and these guys have been working their butts off every Tuesday and Thursday, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah.
But you got to come into this big crowd. You got to show what you got.
Yeah. I mean, sparring is nothing like the real thing. I've never boxed myself, but Leonard Siegel, who's actually going to fight later tonight, he actually told me that. He said sparring is really never going to get you ready for those nerves you're going to feel on fight day.
Some more back and forth punches, not even really strong, but they're landing them, that's for sure.
Wiersma, that left jab is just super powerful. Correa knocked back every single time he throws one.
Correa in the red looking a little sloppy, but he's not losing it.
Still standing up here. You can tell Correa swaying back.
That right hook there.
Meet at the center of the ring, bit of a standoff. They burned off a lot of energy in that first round.
Now starting to slow down, yes.
They're looking for some strategy here. Looking to get some nice hits. Correa able to get a few. Correa grabs him up there. Still good to go here in the second round.
Correa
at the same time. Looks like he's holding him there.
I think Correa, the sophomore in the red, is getting
getting
a little edge on it.
And, you know, I think that's everything that's built up from last year. He lost last year, bit of a landslide victory. He came back. He wants revenge.
Yes.
You know, it may have not been Wiersma that he lost to, but he still wants to win this year.
Mm-hmm. That's for sure.
You see Mariano Sandoval, another sophomore, hyping up Correa a bit, you know, representing class of 25. So Mars' fight was actually canceled tonight due to, you know, multiple reasons, not one big one in particular, but still coaching, still being a big part of this 46th annual fight night. Love to see it.
I know Aiden Correa, he is in my Spanish 2 class, and I know he's been looking forward to this fight for a while. Fellow sophomore.
Like we said previously, you know, Correa lost. This is a big revenge time right here. So Correa is in the brown corner wearing red. Wiersma in the white corner wearing blue. You know, any time that headlight up in the ceiling of the alumni gym turns on, you know something big is going on. Whether it's a wrestling match against, you know, some crazy team from Indiana, or whether it's fight night, it's always going to be fun here.
Special place here, alumni gym.
My favorite part of the school. I remember coming here for fight
night. Oh!
Big hit there. Correa falls to the ground, loses his balance. Wiersma hyping up the crowd here a bit. Bouncing around the ring. Ref has to put him in his place. He's getting excited here, folks. Correa looks to be okay there. Gives a little head nod to the ref. Wiersma coming out strong again. It's that left jab that seems to be getting Correa.
Correa's not scared, though.
No, he's coming right back at him. He took the hit, and now he's going, getting as many hits as he can.
Now it's getting a little sloppy when I was talking about it earlier, but it's got to be from that stamina loss.
As you can see, they're just throwing their hands here.
These guys are tired.
Yeah. Really tired, as you just said, Marty. That's going to be it here, though.
Cow.
Now we've got the announcer, Clem DeLuca, to finish off the first bout.
What did I tell you? The night just started. This is why we have to have... How many of you think you know exactly how to judge this fight? How to score this fight? You got to be careful, because judging an amateur fight is a lot different than what you think. But these guys were fantastic. No matter what, let's give them a nice round of applause. Now, here are some of the... Where's MyJack products? MyJack. Where is MyJack? One of our big sponsors. MyJack is sitting somewhere. Is MyJack here? Thank you. Thank you. Tell them we really appreciate their sponsorship. MyJack products. The judges have made their decision. Who do you think it is? In the blue corner, where's Ma?
What a great matchup, yeah. Matt, for the first round of this 46th annual fight night here at Mount Carmel. Evan Wiersma in the blue corner gets the victory.
Yep. You know, that's a tough loss for Correa, but even getting in the ring, is a victory of itself. You know, personally, I would never box. That is terrifying to me. I mean, I do not have the courage to stand in front of hundreds of people. So, you know, preps to Correa, for doing that. Great job.
Thanks. I don't know if we could take each one. You might just have to give it to him. Rogers Roofing. Where is Rogers Roofing? East side. Rogers Roofing, thank you. Thank you very much. Big sponsorship. That's what we're happy for. Okay, boxers, enter the ring. Now, those of you who have a program see that this is an exhibition, which means you have two talented guys. They do not match in weight, but because they were there all the time, we're giving them both an opportunity. So let's be sure we thank them for that. Out of the blue corner, he's a freshman. His name is Frank Berkey. And out of the red corner, he's also a freshman. His name is Dominic DeLuca.
All right, Marty, right off the bat there, you can see there's a lot of applause for DeLuca. I saw a smirk on Frank Burke's face. He wants this win. It may be an exhibition, but he's taking this seriously.
Oh, yeah.
Staring down DeLuca. It's a 20-pound difference.
20 pounds, yes.
Frank is 130. DeLuca is 110. And while this wasn't on our top three bets of the night, I might throw it up there.
That's for sure.
Both of them come out strong. DeLuca gets, like, so many hits on him. This is insane. Frank Burke is... Oh,
the crowd's going crazy here in the alumni gym.
Frank Burke gets lit up right away. DeLuca puts at least 10 hits on him. The alumni gym is going insane, like you just said, Marty. Gonna take a little break here. DeLuca isn't even afraid of stamina here. He is going just fast. Speed is his main thing here. He's not even worried about fatigue, as you can see. Getting even more hits on Frank.
The combos are crazy.
Whew. Frank is going for body shots. DeLuca more focused on the head.
Dom knows what he's doing. I've heard from a few students at Mount Carmel that Dom DeLuca, that's what he specializes in coming in with those combos. And he's a smart, he may be small, but he's a smart boxer. And we'll see if he can finish it out here in this exciting round one.
No, DeLuca isn't coming out here thinking, hey, I'm going to be like Muhammad Ali. You know, he's thinking speed. He's going right through Brankfurk. Frank coming in now, goes low. DeLuca misses for one of the first times in this round here. And DeLuca going with those uppercuts, some jabs, getting a lot of headshots on Burke.
What a first round.
What a first round. I mean, just exciting. That's the one word I would give to the second bout here. They're going to let Frank go here. That's the end of the first round. And, you know, Marty, I would definitely say DeLuca won that right there.
Oh, yeah, for sure. A lot of people, I mean, these two are freshmen. These guys,
oh, yeah.
You'd think these guys, no one really knows about them in the school. But, I mean, Frank Burke is sort of an underdog here, despite being, some might say he's an underdog, despite being 20 pounds heavier. But everyone in this gym knows who Dom DeLuca is. I think he's a pretty friendly guy. Gets to talk to a lot of people.
Burke was a member of the wrestling team. DeLuca, a member of the football team. They've both made their mark here at Mount Carmel.
Oh, yeah.
A lot of guys know DeLuca, and a lot of guys know Burke through that JV wrestling team. Dominant program here at Carmel. A couple of guys won individual state. Burke still standing, still got a smirk on his face. He's smiling, he's having fun, staring down DeLuca here.
Now
they meet at the center of the ring.
If he wants to take a victory, he's got to show up here. Dom using that speed. Quick in the red.
They're still going at each other. Ooh.
Little shove from Burke.
Little shove into the ropes.
DeLuca just almost knocked Burke's headgear on. Headgear off. Dom's getting a little hyped down there too.
He's ready to go. He's ready for another round, but I believe they're gonna call this one to DeLuca. And you know, you love to see it. Frank is still smiling through it all. That was a great intramural boxing fight right there. That's exactly what you want. A lot of effort, a lot of energy burned up there.
Gotta
respect
the love show.
That's Mount Carmel for you, two buddies.
Here we go, the announcer DeLuca, gonna close it off here.
I'll tell you, that was better than Las Vegas. That was the best fight these two guys put up in a long time. Give them a nice round of applause, two freshmen. So, as they're getting their awards, I know we got to move the show along, so this is it. No contest.
So they're gonna call it no contest, an exhibition round. Both still gonna get their chains with that gold glove at the end of it. That was a great bout to start off the night.
Boy, that was one, I'll tell you, 3 minutes of that, you gotta be in good shape. Not yet, not yet, not yet, Danny. Hold him off. South. United Auto Workers, Local 551. Where's the United Auto Workers? Thank you very much for a great sponsorship. We are very, very thankful for your sponsorship. I hope my car keeps running, I'll tell you. Okay. Steelhead Corporation. Steelhead Corporation. Where's Steelhead Corporation? Is that you guys? Steelhead Corporation, thank you. Great sponsorship. Thank you very, very much. Okay, here we go, the third round of the evening.
Now on to the third bout, 140-pound weight class.
Okay, at 140 pounds, he's a freshman. He's out of the red corner. His name is Dan Keating. And at 140 pounds, he's out of the blue corner. He's a sophomore. His name is Angelo Carraro.
And here we go with our third bout of the night. As said by Mr. Clem DeLuca, we have the 140-pound bout featuring Dan Keating, a freshman, in the red and the brown on brown corner on your screen. And in the blue or white corner on your screen, you can see we have Angelo Correa, a sophomore. And yes, that is a twin brother of Aiden Correa, who just fought in the first bout. So here we go.
Both sophomores. Now, here on the night, you get to the interesting rounds. Little freshman-sophomore matchup.
A little backing off here.
Looking to avenge his brother a bit, get a win for the family. Correa going in here. He's got Keating on the ropes, but Keating fighting back a bit. Loses his balance there. Able to get back up. They meet at the center of the ring.
Now this is a different approach from what we've seen earlier. Whoa.
Ooh, almost falls a bit. Correa went in for a right jab.
A little bit of standoff. It's common to boxing. Wasn't really common in those first two bouts. So these guys are a little smarter in their approach in boxing, but we'll see who comes out as the aggressor.
Now, those standoffs are very important. You're bringing your energy back up. You're not burning all of it, right? Got stamina enough. You're not getting too fatigued here.
Yep.
Keating backing off a lot.
Got to save some of that energy for the third round.
Keating spun around there on the ropes. But that's going to be the end of the first round. You know, that's just a huge difference between the DeLuca and Burke first round and this Correa and Keating first round. Huge difference here.
These guys are in it for the long run. Usually, if you take this sort of approach, kind of taking your time, waiting it out to the third round, you'll be able to make a strong, aggressive move, possibly win.
Definitely right, Marty. Strong, aggressive moves, those standoffs is what is going to help these guys in the third bout here. Correa lost last year, has an 0-1 record overall for fight night. Keating is a freshman, so this is his first time in the ring. We're two bouts deep. Now the second round of the third fight.
Interested to see if they will keep that same approach with a mix of standoffs and aggressive little combos.
Mm-hmm.
We'll see if you noticed Angelo Correa in the blue and the white on your screen corner kind of took those aggressive combos.
Yeah.
We'll see if Keating mixes it up, tries to get an up head.
So far it's been pretty equal of a fight. This second round is going to determine who's going to take the win, I think.
Keating
holding him off here.
That hug to bring them together. Kind of reset.
Going to reset, go back at it. Now in the center of the ring, Keating backs off to the corner. Correa with a big hit there. Keating loses his balance. Looks down to the floor, still going at it. Correa got him up against the ropes. Keating is running away, trying to hold him off, shove him off, do anything he can.
Correa's landing a few good combos right in the face. Nothing too special, though.
Going to take a timeout here. I think there's something wrong with Keating's headgear. But yeah, Correa, he's taking the upper hand here in the second round. Keating just seems to be running away a bit. He's got to be a lot more aggressive if he wants to beat him.
Yeah, that's for sure. Correa's locked and loaded, ready to go.
Yeah. You know, just like Wiersma in that first fight, bouncing around in the corner, you know, cheering up the crowd, trying to get him going here. Very exciting night so far.
Correa kind of just staring him down there.
Yeah.
He's ready. I don't know.
He's ready to go.
Headgear? Oh, there goes his mouth guard.
He lost his mouth guard. I think there was something wrong with his headgear. It did get knocked off a bit with Correa's big right jab there in the corner. Still calling a timeout.
Is that round? Or?
Yeah, I think that's the round. That could definitely mess with Correa's mental game, though. Yeah. He's standing off in the corner, ready to go. Now they're just going to call it, give him a timeout. But it could also help him, you know, give him some water. It's going to be interesting here in the third round. Going to see what happens.
I mean, yeah, if Keating wants to win this fight, he's got to. I know he might be taking a different approach. Maybe he's just scared. Yeah. We don't know. But if he wants to win, he has to go now. It's go time.
Yep, Correa definitely won that second round, in my opinion. Knocked off Keating's headgear a bit. I still think there might be a problem with it. Looks like they're fixing it, but they called that round. We're moving on to the last one of the third bout. Just to recap, Junior Evan Wiersma won the first one, and there was no contest in the exhibition round between Dom DeLuca and Frank Burke. Gonna restart here.
Another standoff.
Standoff, center of the ring. Keating trying to get low. Correa fakes that left jab, goes at him. Got Keating in the ropes. Keating still backs off, dodges that.
Little dodge. He's got to go now, though.
Yeah, pushes him off a bit. Time running out here. Keating's got to go if he wants to take the win. Correa backing off. He knows he has the upper hand, so he's going strategic with these moves. Keating able to land a nice right jab. Able
dodge,
to evade some.
Dodge.
Nice dodges by the freshman. Still go time. Time running out here. Another standoff. Correa. Keating backs off into the corner again. Correa misses that right jab. Gets out of the way. Nice evade. Nice little dodge there.
Maybe too many evades. I don't know, Matt.
I don't think Keating's going to have enough to win this one.
There's a little wrestling move there.
I think Correa's got the win. Something wrong with Keating's headgear again. Correa just goes at him, but that's going to be it. The end of the third round.
All right, let's give them a nice round of applause.
Announcer Clem DeLuca going to finish it off.
You know, that's why in intramural boxing like this, each round is 1 minute. Now, you would think from seeing 3-minute rounds in professional boxing that it would be easy to go 2 or 3 minutes. Well, it's not. After 1 minute and holding 16-ounce gloves in their hands is a experience that really puts them in shape. Intramural boxing, 1 minute rounds, and 16-ounce gloves makes it a big difference. And another thing, in a bout like this, I don't know how many of you are keeping track, but this is why you need professional, here they are, nice round, you need professional judges. It's not that easy. Judging amateur intramural boxing is very different. And the winner, out of what corner do you think won? The winner out of the blue corner, Carrera.
You know, Marty, not a lot of a surprise there. I definitely, Correa had the upper hand in that second round. You can see they were both a little nervous in the first one, but Correa was able to settle in, and I think that was mainly experience.
Yeah, that's for sure.
I think Correa just had a lot more knowledge of, you know, to be aggressive. I think Keating just had to be, you know, get used to it. So we're moving on to our fourth bout of the night, the 235-pound weight class.
Where is high power? Electric. Thank you, guys. Thank you for a great sponsorship. We really do appreciate it. It's great for Mount Carmel. Thank you. high-powered electric. And we have okay, here we go. At 235 pounds, out of the red corner, Dominic Rodo, a sophomore. At 235 pounds, a senior out of the blue corner, Bobby Madena.
Here we go, Marty. Big, big matchup here. Talking about weight, we're talking about expectations. Dom Rado, 1-0 in fight night history. Beat a freshman last year. Coming from class of 25, he's a sophomore. Facing Bobby Madena, class of 23. A huge spark on the football team. He had an interception in the state championship game. I remember that was a huge moment. As a defensive lineman, I mean, nobody was really expecting it. Came out of nowhere. Huge play. Able to beat Batavia 44-20, 14-0 state champs. Here we go.
See if you can bring the football skills. Oh!
Yeah. Big dodge
football
by
skills
Dotto
out of the
there.
Boxing room.
Dotto's just going at him. So is Madena. They're both very good at dodging those right and left jabs. Get caught up in the ropes there.
A lot of big, big, big punches from Madena in the blue. But Rado's hanging in there. He's getting some big shots, too.
Yes, for sure. Touching gloves a bit there. Doing it again. Looking to hold him off. Let's see who's going to take the first move. It's going to be Rado. Misses that right jab. Madena comes right back at him. He's going to hold off, though. Stand off. Center of the ring.
Getting ready to make their move. Little dives there from Madena.
Who's going to take the first one? Still touching gloves a bit. Knocking each other off. Madena holding off the center of the ring there. He's got Rado up against these ropes. Big nice left jab by Madena. Rado knocked back a bit. Let's see if he can get back into it. We're going to call the first round. Pretty equal, but I would say Madena got a lot of big hits in there.
Yes.
I would say he's got the upper hand right now.
He's using those aggressive defensive lineman moves.
Yeah.
Bringing him right to the boxing ring. It shows that he has that aggressiveness that he used on the football field.
For sure, yeah.
And is bringing it right onto this boxing ring. You could see Madena kind of dominating the center of the ring, which leads to more confidence, more need for aggressiveness, just a better confident feel on winning this fight.
Yeah. Both guys are super aggressive. You know, it's a lot different from the last bout we had, but I think that was just mainly experience, weight class, a lot of factors played into it. These guys are hungry for a win. Madena and Rado going at it here.
Interesting to see if Dominic Rado in the red kind of taking a more aggressive approach in this round two. More dominant approach, I should say.
Yep. Rado in the red, Madena in the blue. Bit of a standoff here. Madena
big dodge
by Madena. Rado steps back a bit. Gonna meet in the center of the ring. Madena with another dodge. Really good on defense. Rado going at him. Oh, he falls. Let's see if he's all right.
Jeez.
That could have been bad. I mean, ropes caught him.
A little too aggressive there.
Yeah, knee back at the middle.
Big, big punches.
You know, Rado, he's still able to hold him off a bit. And Madena almost jumped there. He got so high.
Kind of running
away. Madena's running away. Rado able to get a nice hit on him. Bit of a standoff here. Madena with a nice right jab there. Not very powerful. Still got a hit, though. That's going to be the end of the second round.
Madena looked like he was ready to deliver a nice right hook there towards the end of that round.
Yeah.
I'm sure.
all of the donors who have stepped up to support the young men who attend MC.
Men of Carmel don't simply reach goals, they exceed them. And they're grateful to people you like who help them along the way. Thank you for your support this Men of Carmel week.
Right, we're back. Start of the third round here. And I really don't know who has the upper hand. I'm being genuine. I mean, Rado fell in the last round, but he's still being very aggressive, maybe a little too aggressive. These guys got a lot of power coming in.
We'll see if they maintain their stamina. Oh, I think they have.
Yeah, these guys still not tired yet. Rado running right at Medina. Medina throwing up those hands.
Some sloppy punches maybe.
Yeah. A bit sloppy, but Rado's looking for anything to give him the win.
Yes.
Another standoff here. Rado looks a lot more comfortable than in those first two rounds. Medina keeps turning away from him, able to push Rado off.
See if one of these big punches will land for Medina. Maybe.
Ooh,
there
big
you go.
Left jab. Just like you said, Marty. Lands a big one, comes right back at him. And Medina seems to have this tactic of he runs away and then out of nowhere turns around, gets a huge punch, big punch on Rado. Like right here. He backs off a bit. You see he transfers that weight forward. That's going to be the end of the fourth bout here tonight. We're going to have announcer Clem DeLuca finish it off.
Boy, no wonder we had such a terrific football team this year. Hey, and here comes Jordan Lynch, our championship coach. Let's give him a nice round of applause. After the judges make their decision, we're going to slow things down just a little bit. We're moving along quite well. I want to get you out of here by 9:45. That's our regular time. But boy, oh boy, we got a lot to go. So far, what do you think of the action? What a good show. What do you guys think? The judges have made their decision. The winner is out of the blue corner. Medina.
You know, Marty, that was a very close fight.
Very aggressive fight, too.
Yeah,
yes.
Yeah, just about to say it. I mean, these guys, they gave it their all. I'm sure they both want a nice nap right now.
Here we go.
From the amount of stamina they just used and energy they burned off.
Now listen up, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to slow things down again. Say hello to our famous coach, Jordan Lynch. And do you guys recognize this guy, our famous quarterback, Blaney Downing? What a show they gave us this year. I think not only were we championship football team, we won the championship for the most penalties. Okay, I didn't mean that. This is a special award. Please listen up. This is a special award we're awarding to our leader, Jack Griffiths. I didn't say much about him at the beginning because I knew we had a lot to say about him now. So, Jack Riffus is the leader of Fight Night. He's been doing this for the most part of his life, 43 years and still going. Jack Riffus. This award giving out by the football team is because he's the one with all the Fathers Club that does the cooking before the game, sells tickets. He is a wonderful asset. He helps what make Fight Night what it is. How would you like to get a helmet and put it on your mantle? Jordan Lynch and Blaney Downing, thank you. Boy, oh boy, let's give Jack a hand. Let's give Jack a hand. That's a Mount Carmel award. Not just Fight Night, not just football. That's a Mount Carmel award to one of the great men in the history of Mount Carmel. And I've been working with him a long time, and I'll tell you, he is one crabby son of a gun. Okay, here we go. Consolidated Fabrics. Where's Consolidated Fabrics? South End. What a sponsorship. This is a big time sponsorship. Thank you very much. Mount Carmel appreciates it. Thank you all. Consolidated Fabrics and Contractors.
Well, Marty, looks like we're gonna have the bagpipes come around here again. We're coming up on our fifth bout of the night, the 170-pound class.
So in the red corner, or the brown corner on your screen, we have Tim McInerney, a 1-0 Mount Carmel Fight Night boxer.
Okay, we got so much going on here tonight,
and
it's hard
Mr.
to keep track.
Clem DeLuca will take it away.
But the main thing you're here for is to buy some raffle tickets. Hey, Tony DeFilippo, hello. Where's our president, Brandon Conroy? We didn't have a seat for our president. Julie, what happened to our president? Okay, here we go. At 170 pounds. He is out of the blue corner at 170 pounds, a sophomore, Emmett Winters. And at 170 pounds, a sophomore, out of the red corner, his name is Tim McInerney.
You know, heard the man.
Yep. Out of these 26 fighters, 11 of them are sophomores.
These two sophomores, as I told you earlier, these guys are going to bring a hell of a fight here. Emmett Winters, one of my good buddies. I know he's been working hard. So has Tim McInerney.
Yep.
Here we go.
This is Winters' first fight night. Tim beat Leonard Siegel last year, 1-0 record. Looking to keep his undefeated fight night record here. Starting off a bit scrappy.
McInerney
still going
in the upper hand here. Winters making a little comeback.
Some nice body shots by Winters coming in. McInerney going for the head though. Edging him on a bit. Winters nice dodge, moving back a bit. McInerney had a chance to take a big hit there. Winters stays on his feet though. A lot of defensive moves coming in here.
These guys are displaying their training that they've been working hard on.
Yeah.
Very well.
Both taking some hits there.
McInerney.
Winters up against the ropes, though.
McInerney's landing a lot of shots.
You know, towards the end of that first round, Tim definitely had the upper hand.
Now, as I told you, and I kind of predicted, these guys are good, solid boxers. They have been working their butts off over the past couple months. And, yeah, as you said, Matt, they've taken a little defensive approach. Being smart boxers, not using all of their energy in the first round. But Tim McInerney taking a little bit of a lead there.
Yeah, for sure. You know, they're both slowly getting rid of those nerves. You know, just thinking about what's going on in the ring, not what what's going on up on the track, what's going on outside. They're getting more focused as they go on. I could definitely see that with McInerney. But nice aggressive, a lot of defense coming in, though, unlike the fight we just had before with Dom Rado and Bobby Medina. That was just pure athleticism, yeah. Power, and aggressiveness. Now moving on, bit, you know, lower weight class, going to be a lot more strategy coming in.
See if Emmett Winters, my guy, can take a little more aggressiveness, a little more shots landed with those punches.
Mm-hmm. You know, it's his first fight night. He's got to slowly get into it, but I do agree with you on that. McInerney able to land some nice hits. Winters coming right back, though. Lands a left jab there. Misses on the next one, though.
Lots of dodges and lots of missed punches from both guys.
Emmett's still going at him.
Winter's coach is cheering him on.
Yeah.
I believe that is Coach Cowboy, a freshman football coach, a running back here at Mount Carmel. I remember Emmett telling me he was going to coach him, and he is loud.
Yeah. Screaming at Emmett. And, you know, Emmett, he's using that coaching. I mean, he's doing very well in the second round here. McInerney able to make a little bit of a comeback. Winter's still going at him.
Winters looks like he's slowing down a little bit.
Yeah. Both look a bit fatigued there. They're going to shake it off. We're moving into the last round. A lot of power towards the end of that second round, but a lot of burnt energy, some fatigue going on. We're going to see how tired they are in the last round here.
Noticing a lot of backward steps from Emmett Winters and a lot of forward steps from Tim McInerney, showing that Tim kind of has the upper edge on here. A good lead. I believe Emmett can step it up here if he wants to win. He's got it in him.
Thank you to the parents, family, and friends of Mount Carmel who donated to make our annual walkathon a success.
Our students, staff, and even a few four-legged friends enjoyed a beautiful 10K along Lake Michigan yesterday.
Yep, great day yesterday. A nice little walk, and then I had practice right after. My legs were burning when I came home.
Oh, yeah.
So,
got to give a shout-out to Garrett, man.
Yep.
My brother, I didn't even know he was running. We had a group of 30 guys ran in that walkathon, and all of a sudden, walking back, see him in, like, sixth place, blew our minds. That, you know, big linebacker could run that fast.
You know, I heard Garrett's main sport is darts with his dad, Dan Man.
Oh, boy.
He's on his dad's dart team, so I was kind of surprised when he said he was running for the walkathon.
Here's some aggressiveness from Emmett Winters.
Yeah.
That's what we needed.
Exactly what they needed in the last bout. McInerney misses that left uppercut. And Emmett is coming right back. These guys are tired. You can tell. They made it the center of the ring. Bit of a standoff. Emmett looking for anything he can get. Winters doing a great job. Tim is too, though.
His arms are kind of wailing there. Yeah. Still got some good punches here.
Still standing. He looks good. Oh, almost had him on the ropes there. Tim able to get away.
Some jabs right in Winter's face.
Tim puts his hands down for a second. Emmett takes advantage of the moment. Hit each other at the same time there. McInerney lands a nice right jab.
Coach Cowboy cheering on Emmett, telling him to go now.
That was a great fight overall. They were, you know, they saved their energy for the end. You could say they looked tired, but that was a great fight overall. And I honestly can't tell you who won that one.
Yep.
Very, very close.
Thank you, thank you. Thank you, Dan LeCount. Hey, guys, how's it going up there? Thank you, doing a good job, boy. Is anybody downstairs watching this downstairs? There are? Okay. Hello to all you folks downstairs. That's Mount Carmel for you. We got them all over doing their job. Mike, do not, hold on, hold on. We're gonna have a special announcement here in a second. How about this fight, wasn't it? Amateur boxing, 16-ounce gloves. They do a great job. The judges have made their decision. The winner is out of the red corner, McEnany. Now, fighters do not enter the ring. Thank you, guys. That was a great job. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, here now. Hang on, everybody. Hang on. Where is Jessica McCaskill? Jessica McCaskill. Jessica is the undisputed lightweight champion of the world. Here she is. On June 24th in Madison Square Garden, she's fighting for the championship. Whoever is taking Jessica home tonight better be real careful. Oh, you are. Ay, ay, ay. Jessica McCaskill, thank you for coming to our show. Thank you. We have a special award. This special award is the Mike Fitzgerald Award, the guy who started this whole thing with Jack Griffiths. So, if anybody is here from the Mike Fitzgerald family, please come up. The great Mike Fitzgerald. He's the one that recruited me and brought me here. The Mikey Fitz Award. If the Fitzgerald family isn't here, goes to one of our all-time great alumni coaches. His name is Danny Letts. Let's get a nice round of applause for Danny Letts.
Hey, thanks, man.
Danny, I won't read the award because as it is, my throat's getting soft. So enjoy the award, the Fitz Award. Here we go. And the last, now listen, intermission. We are gonna have a very, very short intermission. No, after this fight, we're gonna have a short intermission. So, we just don't have the time. So boxers, enter the ring.
Well, Marty, I mean, just to kind of recap that Tim McInerney and Emmett Winters fight very, very close. You know, great job to both Tim and Emmett.
Okay.
Now we're moving on to our last
bout
before intermission.
Whoa, don't jump around too much. at 260 pounds. Both are football players. I better get out of the ring. You better be careful. Football players. Out of the red corner, his name, a sophomore, James McCaskill. And out of the blue corner, if Brian's family is here, I apologize for what I'm going to do to this name. I'm going to try the best I can. Lukasik. I got it. Brian Lukasik. Okay.
Well, Marty, great start to this sixth bout we have tonight. Just like Clem DeLuca said, Mr. DeLuca, these guys are both football players. They both work extremely hard during the season. Brian is actually a transfer. He came here after winter break. James, been here both 2 years. This is both their first time doing fight night. Gonna touch gloves here. This is gonna be a lot of power coming out. Brian throwing his hands at him. Just puts James up against the ropes. James comes right back at him. Nice little uppercut there. And Brian just has his head down. I think that might be his strategy. Doesn't want to get any
Brian's
hits to the
beat
head.
Up here. What but, the?
Yeah, I mean, if I was Brian, I would stand up, you know? Put your hands up, but he's just got his head kind of buried in the ground there. James, yeah.
He already looks tired.
I mean, he's hanging out in the corner, crossing his arms, doesn't really care, you know?
I know these guys worked out in Caravan Tough, the football workout program. These guys are in their own lifting group, so they know each other pretty well.
Yep.
But I know Brian's very aggressive, and he does not care about friendship.
No. James has to.
James is confused. I don't know what's going on.
James has to run a bit. James has to run away there a bit. They're gonna call the first round. This is an interesting fight so far. And when we mute our mics, I'm definitely not gonna laugh here.
A lot of running around from Brian, head ducking, taking on all the punches James could give.
Yeah. I don't really know what to say. All right.
Little sloppy, you know.
They're so big, they kind of have to be sloppy. I think they're not very coordinated in that way. So, it's been a great fight so far. Did you know that today, April 29th, marks the 99th anniversary of the groundbreaking of this very building? Construction on our main building was started on this date in 1924.
Celebrate this incredible milestone with a donation of your own. Visit www.mchs.org/donate now to get us started.
Donations have been coming in the past week through the Men of Carmel Fund and Walkathon. Right now, though, we're going to start the second round of the 260-pound weight bout. And Brian, he keeps putting his head down. He's worrying me a bit because James doesn't really have the option of hitting him in the head. He kind of has to go for those body shots. He's trying to push Brian off.
There's Brian sloppy. I don't even want to call him punches. They're slaps.
It's interesting.
He's dead.
He's gassed.
He's gone.
Somebody get that man some water. Oh my God. He's gassed out here. We just started the second round.
A little bit of slow motion here.
They need some water.
Get him, James. Get him, James. Get him, Irish.
We call James McCormick Big Irish.
He's just, I mean, it's hard not to laugh at this. These guys are huge, and they're just going at each other.
It's Ireland versus Poland right here.
Yep. We got the Polish flag off in the corner. We got a bit of a student section going on.
Brian's hanging his head. He's tired. James got his hands behind his back. He's ready to go.
Brian's thinking about that nice bottle of water he's going to get after this bout is over. As for right now, they're going to call it off.
He's got to walk over there first. I mean, I think that round was definitely an improvement from the first round. James and Brian both showing off some strong punches, but I think it's Brian he's kind of losing his energy. I don't know. He's just getting really sloppy.
These guys are gassed right now. You can just see. I mean, I think Brian a lot more than James. James, he's keeping his focus. He's got more of a strategy. I think Brian's just, you know, he's a lot more. I think he's a bit more uncoordinated. I know James does have some experience with boxing. I'm not so sure about Brian, so this could be more of an experience thing. But it's been an exciting fight so far. Definitely the best one so far tonight.
Yeah, exciting. Yeah. I wouldn't say skill, but exciting. Yeah,
exciting for sure.
See how much Brian's got in the tank.
There we go.
Oh, there you go.
He's got him in the corner. It's James. Big Irish, go ahead.
Those aren't even punches.
I don't know what's going on.
He's being aggressive, though. You got to give him props for that.
What?
Little push off to James.
You know, usually, Marty, for the big moments in the night, I'll say what just happened. But I think right now I have to say it. What just happened? I mean, James just got shoved to the ground.
James is mad.
Well, he's mad. He's mad. These big boys are hungry for the W. James, he wants it.
Brian's slouching on the edge of the ring. I think he's tired.
Time
James hanging
bit.
Over a little bit. Oh, there you go. There you go, Brian. Take a nap there, bud.
You deserve the break, man.
James is squatting.
What is going on? This is so random. Here we go. Come on, somebody.
I wouldn't be surprised for a random powerful punch here.
Somebody land a punch, man. This is where boxing
there you
is
go,
beautiful.
There you go.
These standoffs right here in the center of the ring. Oh man.
Punch him. Let's go.
I can't announce it. James just runs away. He starts shaking his head.
What do you think these coaches are thinking?
They're not even saying anything. They don't know what to say.
Come on, James.
Here we go.
Come on, Brian.
Touch glove. Brian. Oh, no, that was actually an attempt there. And they're gonna call it.
Wow, what about that one?
I don't know what to say. You know what, Marty?
He still thought the fight was going on.
What just happened?
Yeah, he said my thing.
Look at these guys. All right,
we're going to let announcer Clem DeLuca take it away.
1 minute. Here. 1 minute with 16-ounce gloves, and look at that. That's called getting into shape. You know, we're going to have an intermission coming up, but it's going to be a short one because we don't want the night to go too long. So Joe Kilroy, Vinny Pamendieri, and you guys downstairs cooking, be sure to save me a beef sandwich and a sausage sandwich. I haven't had Italian bread since Christmas. I have not eaten Italian bread since Christmas. Am I gonna make up for it tonight? Okay. That's going to be fun. There'll be a short intermission. Boy, these two guys really went at it. So the judges have made their decision. That's why we bring judges in from not Mount Carmel, because it's an unbiased decision. The judges made their decision. The winner is out of the red corner, Beckhammer.
Oh. Oh, right.
I don't even know what to say about
it. All right, everyone, enjoy the food.
You gotta give congrats,
James. If you
James,
can get a drink, buy yourselves a drink.
These guys worked their asses off.
We're not going to be long.
We're going to be interviewing James during intermission.
We have a big second half coming up.
Yep.
A big second half.
Really big second half. I mean,
you're going to enjoy the second half. Thank
you, guys. Just to name some kids off, Muha, Asher, Fleck, Winters, Emmett's brother. Yeah, Gohuli for sure, big hitter. So, I mean, very big matchup here. We're going to have some interviews coming up during intermission, though.
Got a little recognition from James.
Yep. Going to be coming up real soon. Congratulations to Mr. Dan LeCount and Mr. Craig Ferguson, who were inducted into the Chicago Catholic League Coaches Association Hall of Fame this past week.
Mr. LeCount and Mr. Ferguson have made incredible contributions to the Chicago Catholic League and have helped to inspire greatness in the many athletes they have impacted through the years. Congratulations to you both on this well-deserved honor.
In case you're wondering what's going on, this is Mikey Fitz's grandson. So he's here belated to hand the award to our wonderful and famous Danny Letts. We got pictures of it. Thank you, son. Thank you. Thank you. Are you a freshman?
No, I'm in eighth grade.
You're in eighth grade. Are you coming to Mount Carmel?
We look forward to seeing our alumni and friends here at Mount Carmel on Friday night for the 86th annual alumni banquet.
Please purchase your tickets on the alumni tab of our Mount Carmel website.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, we have James McCormick, sophomore fighter, here for a little post-fight interview.
Hello.
James, how did it feel getting up in the ring here?
Pretty good, actually. I loved it, man. I love it. I'm going to do it again next year.
All right.
It was awesome. You get in the ring, and all of a sudden, you can't hear the very large crowd.
Yeah.
It's fucking amazing. Oh, crap. My bad. It's amazing.
It's all right. It's all right. Failed don't worry about it.
4 seconds after you told me to not swear.
Well, it's... James.
Whoops.
It's all right, James. It's all right.
James, it's okay. We'll figure it out. So how did those nerves feel stepping into the ring?
I was nervous, but I've been here since 4 o'clock, so I've had a lot of time to get off those nerves, warming up, not going in there cold. Yeah. I mean, I was nervous, but then I got in there. All of a sudden, it's just, I can't, you're not thinking.
Yeah, yeah.
James, what do you think about the overall matchup and how it went going up against Brian, your buddy?
I mean, like, I felt a little bad because I didn't want to fight my friend, but... I liked it. I thought it was good.
Yeah?
There are some other matchups I'm more excited for tonight.
Okay.
Asher versus Fleck being the main one.
Would you say that friendship just, like, completely dropped?
Yeah, probably. Yeah.
Well.
That's gone. Ship sailed.
I hope that ship can stay in the port, buddy. You had a fantastic fight. You know, I saw Brian had that strategy. He put his head down. He didn't want to take any hits to the head.
Yeah, no, that was interesting.
Yep.
There.
Very unique.
Yep. How did you respond to it?
I just kept hitting him in the side of the head because you can't cover your entire face with your arms.
Okay.
And he seemed to be a little shaky at the end there. I hope he's all right.
All right. Well, that strategy got you the W. We're all very proud of you. Actually, Brian is right up here on the track. I hope you guys can connect after that great fight. The most enjoyable so far of the night.
James, really? No fighting. No fighting.
No fighting up on the...
You fought in the ring. I don't want you to fight up here.
You sure so. Destroy your camera equipment. Be terrible.
Yeah. That would be bad. So, you know, you said you're excited for some other fights. Which one are you most looking forward to?
Asher versus Fleck.
That's what everybody's talking about.
That's amazing.
You know, I heard
last fight of the night. Mm-hmm. Oh, it's going to be great.
You know, my buddy Saul Goodman is very excited for it. He's been posting a lot on social media getting ready for it.
Oh, that's crazy.
Yeah, it's crazy the amount of recognition these guys are getting. So, James, incredible job. You got your chain here.
Yeah.
So, you know, this was your first year doing it. How does it feel? To step in, because you know stepping in the ring is an accomplishment in of itself.
Yeah.
How does it feel to take home the W?
Oh, it feels amazing. It feels amazing. Like you said, stepping into the ring itself feels amazing. And props to every guy who stepped in the ring tonight. It's like, it just feels amazing.
All right,
James. What are you gonna do to celebrate? What's the plan for tonight?
I don't think I can say that on here, but I'm gonna probably go out, have some fun.
All
maybe
right.
With you guys, who knows?
Okay.
I'll have to find somewhere to go.
Nice job, James.
The lost sheep at the moment.
Okay, nice job, James. Please keep that friendship in the port here tonight. Go talk to your buddy Brian. Make sure things are right with him.
No fighting. No fighting.
Fantastic job. And get your disgusting mouthpiece off my table. Thank you, James.
Thank you. Sorry for swearing.
Okay.
Broke the one rule.
All right, Marty, that was a fantastic first 5 bouts. We're going to be back real soon.
See you soon.
Would the officials come to ringside? Will the officials come to ringside? Thank you. Okay, officials, take your position. Welcome back. Could someone turn the house lights off? Before we get going, all you guys and gals up there, that's a show. I know you're getting a theater here at Mount Carmel. One of these days you'll have a show that's called Guys and Dolls. And that's the whole crew, that's the whole cast right there. How many of you guys are not from Mount Carmel? How many are not from Mount Carmel High School? You go to another high school. Come on, let me know. No one's gonna throw you off the stands. Raise your hand. If you don't go to Mount Carmel High School and you're here, we want to thank you for coming tonight. We want to thank you all. It's been fun. Okay, let's get started with our... We have a couple more sponsors we want to talk about. Boy, we love the sponsors. Mount Carmel's Father's Club, Alumni Dads. Mount Carmel's Father's Club took an ad, wherever you're at, guys. Thank you, thank you. Are we ready, coaches? Okay, boxers, enter the ring. I want Hi, Joey. Good to see you. Okay, are the officials going here? Danny Kosas is here. Dave, boxers, are you ready? They're not ready. The next young man that's going to start out, his name is Na Katatunga. So, for the parents of Na Katatunga, I hope I'm getting it right. What can I say? I just flew in from Florida. Great weather in Florida, and I'm here in Chicago's weather. Love it. So, out of the... out of the red corner, he's a junior. He's 140 pounds. His name is Nate Katatunga. And 140 pounds, he's a sophomore. He's out of the blue corner, and his name is Ryan McCormick.
And here we go. Nav and Ryan McCormick going at it. Ryan McCormick fought last year, took a tough loss, but I know he's out for revenge tonight.
Oh, it's that time of the night. You start to get to the second half of fight night, building up to that super heavyweight match. But right now we've got a junior, Tuna, sophomore Ryan McCormick.
McCormick in the blue, taking a little aggressive.
You know.
In the aggressive there. Nav, or many students here at Mount Carmel call him Tuna due to his pretty long last name.
Yeah.
In the red, getting the count. Now here we go again. McCormick getting some nice left jabs and a nice right hook there. What a pretty good first round there. I think they called it off.
Oh, yeah. They're taking his headgear off. Oh, yep. I think it's over.
Okay.
We'll let
sometimes that
announcer
happens.
DeLuca take
we
it away.
We want to give them both a nice round of applause for trying. So here they are. Katatunga and McCormick. Referee stops the contest. The winner's out of the blue corner, Ryan McCormick. Anybody who bought a Split the Pot ticket. Split the Pot. The tickets are these yellow tickets. Anybody who bought a yellow ticket, that ticket is worth $900. Split the pot. The winning number is, and I cannot see it, 539061. 539061. $900. Where's the winner? receive the president right here, president of the Fathers Club, Tom Asselmore. $900. Nice to go home. Boxers enter the ring. At 185 pounds, he's a junior. He's out of the blue corner, Vinny Winters. Also at 185 pounds, he's a sophomore out of the red corner, Matt Muha.
All right, Marty, this is another big matchup here. Sophomore Matt Muha, junior Vinny Winters, younger brother Emmett Winters fought earlier today.
These guys are good buddies, but they're very, very aggressive football players.
Yeah, and they're going right at it. Everybody expected this one. Both very aggressive guys. Going right at it.
The speed of the punch is what's going to get them going in this fight. Give him an upper hand. Vinny putting Muha in the corner. As Vinny in the blue takes a few steps back.
Muha coming back here. Getting back into his groove here.
Little standoff here.
Standoff, center of the ring. Muha right in the middle, dodges that left jab from Winters. A lot more strategic than the last few bouts we've seen. That's going to be the end of the first round. Very aggressive coming out of the gates there. I'm very excited for these next two rounds.
Now, Matt, as I said earlier, these two guys are hardworking. When I say hard, I mean top-notch, the hardest-working kids in the weight room on the football team and on the football field, which just goes to show that you know these guys worked their butts off when it came to training for fight night.
These guys are very hard workers. Muha works very hard in chemistry class with Miss Norris, but he works even harder on the field for football.
Yep.
Back at it. Muha takes a nice approach. He's up in the ropes though. Winters almost falls over. Muha's got him.
Muha gave a little shove to Vinny there. We've seen a lot of those kind of little pushing and shoving near the edge of the ring.
Trying to get whatever competitive edge they can. Muha's got that arcing jab. We'll see what they can do here. Still the second round. Bit of a standoff, losing some energy.
Muha wants it. You can see him nodding his head. Little bit of a standoff here. Not much.
See what happens. Lots of standoffs here in the second round. Muha's mad. You can see him walking back to the corner. Really wants this win. Lost last year. Bit of an underdog as a freshman. But he's learned a lot since then, these months leading up to his second fight night.
I've talked to him for a few times about it, the man from Alice, Matt Muha in the red corner, about that matchup from last year. And I remember it almost seemed like he lost all of his energy by the time the third round came. I talked to him a little bit about that, and he said that's definitely what he's going to focus on with this matchup, seeing if he can maintain that energy all the way through.
Yeah, I can definitely tell he's saving energy for this last round, which is definitely going to be the most important in this bout. Let's see, Winters is definitely a lot more calmly than Muha right now because he may have the edge. Nobody knows, but Muha's ready to go.
Yeah.
Muha looking a lot more aggressive just coming out of the gate here.
Vinny putting Muha on the corner and a little spin move.
Probably spins around.
From his football career there.
Yeah. Muha runs right across the court to get up in his face. Looks like he's okay. Now this is the time of the fight. You just got to give it your all. Any hit you can get is worth something right here. It's the last round. They got to give it all they got.
There's a nice left jab from Muha. Vinny's got some moves in him, in his bag.
This is Vinny's first fight night, Muha's second. So while he may be older, that experience factor might play in here for Muha.
Looks like a little fatigue from Winters. See some deep breaths, kind of nodding his head up.
Muha, nice hit there.
That left jab is really working for Muha. But Vinny's landing some too.
Wow!
Overall, a great fight. We're going to let announcer DeLuca take it away.
These two guys are on a football team. I'll tell you, no wonder we got a championship football team. That's wonderful. Now, you folks, I want you to take notice that all these ad signs you see up here are great sponsorship from the people. So if anybody's here that you know regarding these ads, be sure and thank them because it's all for Mount Carmel. The ads go to the school, and the school helps whoever they can getting going. So those ads are very, very important, and we have a lot of ads this year. Julie, did you make up these signs? Julie? No? Okay. What a battle! Who do you think won? Here we go! The second half, we're gonna see some bombs flowing. The winner is out of the red corner, Muha!
What a great fight there for our second bout of this second half.
Thank you, guys.
The 46th annual Mount Carmel Fight Night. I know Muha really wanted that one, Matt Malloy. Especially after coming off of a loss from last year.
Like I said, folks,
great performance by sophomore Matt Muha there, representing our class. Really
proud. I tell you, the weather in Florida, it's so boring. It's always the same. 87 and 70 at night. At least you come to Chicago, and that's what you call weather. One day during this week, the weather changed three times in one day while I was here. That's what I call weather. You know, I recognize all you folks from the football program. It's so good to see you all. I'm very, very happy to see you. Thank you for being here. Boxers, enter the ring. We're moving along real well. You know, folks, if it wasn't for Louis standing here explaining to me the pronunciation of some of these names, I'd butcher it up worse than I do already. Anyway, at 125 pounds, he's a freshman. He's out of the red corner. His name is Sandar Mosqueda. And at 125 pounds, out of the blue corner, he's a junior, and his name is Lucas Tesserius.
Luca Sertzis is the correct
Sorry about the
pronunciation. It's all right, Mr. DeLuca.
You know, I struggle with some of these guys' names too. I'm not going to lie.
Yeah.
Here we go. Freshman junior matchup. Lucas Sertzis
in the red.
Beat Ryan McCormick last year. Got a win on his belt. Comes out strong here. This guy did not back and down, though. A lot of movement.
A lot of footwork.
Yeah. Got him in the corner there. Sertzis coming out dominant. Looking to win 2 years in a row. Ooh, knocks him down. Big right jab by Lucas Sertzis.
Wow. He's still pumped to go.
I mean, that was the first, like, official knockdown of this night. We had one earlier, but, you know, it was really loss of balance, just kind of fell. But, I mean, that was, he fell by that big right jab by Lucas.
You can look, if you look across this gym, everyone's eyes are now focused on this fight. That shocked. These guys are still going.
Yeah.
Full energy.
Mosqueda comes right back, though. Lands two big hits on Sertzis. Now holding him a bit, trying to fight him off with Sertzis. Sertzis backs off a bit. Looking to come back at him. Nice dodge by the freshman.
Very powerful right punches. I should say right hooks from Sertzis in the blue.
These guys are small, but they're fast. Very athletic. Call off the round there. Great first round. Very exciting, kind of bringing everybody back into the second half here right after intermission. But Marty, you're exactly right. You know, there were some people maybe lined up for food, maybe buying some stuff. There were guys, they're on their phone. But no, Mosqueda fell. Everybody was locked in on this fight.
Yeah, these guys, you can tell, Matt, I heard you say these guys are very athletic. It is definitely true. You could see both of these guys, Sandar and Lucas, very good footwork, very good mechanics with landing those punches and some left jabs in. But I think that knockdown might have been the most shock this gym's felt in a while. Very sudden.
Yep, pulling everybody back in. This is our third bout since intermission. A little recap, Ryan McCormick beat the junior, Nath Kuatunga, put a win on his belt, and Matt Muha beat Vinny Winters. Now, the freshman Mosqueda.
Big standoff here.
A lot of excitement for Sertzis. Mosqueda's got some great defense. They're calling a timeout. I think he lost his mouth guard.
Oh, he just forget to put it in?
Maybe, I'm not sure, but
I think you need a mouth guard for boxing.
You know, I think you need one of those. It's kind of like helmets in hockey, right? You know, the goalie got hit in the head 100 times in one game and thought, you know, maybe I need one of these things.
Yep. Sandar keeps punching his red gloves together. He's pumped.
Ready to go. Wraps.
There's some more footwork.
Yeah. Some great footwork by these guys. It's just, you know, that upper body strength. Who's better? Who wants it more? Holds him. Push him off. Gonna push him off. That's the end of that round. Moving on to the last one. Coming up. But, I mean, they're both very, you know, I wouldn't say aggressive, just athletic. They really want to win here. The freshman, Sandar Mosqueda, he really just wants to show off a bit, show what he's got. And Sertzis, he wants to maintain that win he got from last year. So we'll see what happens.
A little bit of fatigue probably resulting in those standoffs. But we'll see if either Lucas or Sandar can turn it around in this final round of this third bout since second intermission. Thank you.
All right, we're back now.
These guys are even using their footwork to get them pumped up.
Here we go.
Standoffs.
Freshman junior matchup. Mosqueda in the red. Sertzis in the blue.
They're very patient with
knowing
when to attack and when to defend.
Sertzis is great with that right hand jab. Comes back a bit, but then uses his balance and all that weight he's got built up to move right in on the freshman. Zandar here backing off a bit. Trying to touch gloves with Sertzis. Sertzis comes right back at him.
I'm noticing a lot of punches from Sandar just coming up short.
You know, that, I think it's that arm strength that's going to be a big factor here in this last round.
Yeah, those 16-ounce gloves, you got to get them across.
Yeah.
Got to go now if you want to take that victory.
Boy, how about these two tough guys, huh?
A little bit of a slower third round. We're going to see who the winner is.
You know, I talk about Florida, but I'm not going back till after the football season. So in case we win the championship, I'll be here again. Bill Morrow, where's Bill Morrow? Southeast corner. Paula Ferro. Paula, these are all sponsors, special guests, ads, Joe Rogan. Boy, this is 3 1-minute rounds. Louie. You know, I've butchered up so many names tonight. I'm really going to screw this one up. So I apologize to the parents. Who do you think the winner is? The judges have made their decision. The winner is out of the blue corner. His name is Cisteris. How'd I do, Julie? No. Okay.
Great bout there. Lucas Sertzis taking the W.
Well, we're working on it. You know, being from the old neighborhood, Taylor Street, I'm not used to Cisteris. So anyway, if the parents are here, I apologize. Boxers, enter the ring.
Here we go.
I see so many faces here from football. I want to wave to all of them. We sit in the stands together. We enjoy the games.
Here we go, we're now onto the 180-pound weight class.
Okay, I think we're ready, and we're doing real good, time-wise. Uh-oh, I recognize this name. Yes, I recognize this name, even coming from Florida. Naples, Florida, it's fantastic. Come and visit us sometime. In the red corner, he's a junior at 180 pounds. He is Ryan Gilhooty. And at 180 pounds, he's a sophomore. His name is Colin Kelly.
All right, here we go, Marty. Huge matchup coming into you. Junior Ryan Gilhooty, sophomore Colin Kelly.
Now, folks at home, prepare yourselves. Ryan Gahuli is going to burst out of this corner of the ring right here.
You know, we just watched him before the fight. Stood off in the corner. Watch the aggression this guy has.
Yep, there you go. That's some right hooks.
Backing him off into the ropes here, and now he's going to take his attack. Kelly doing a great job, able to back him off a bit. He does have that height advantage. Ooh, able to dodge that big right jab. Here we go. Put him in the corner. Gahuli has the upper hand here for sure.
Gahuli displaying that aggressiveness right there. Landing some big punches.
Colin Kelly kind of shaking his head a bit, waving it off. Here we go, Gahuli taking his approach. No standoffs in this one. They're going right at each other the entire time. Here we go, center of the ring. Kelly got some hits in there towards the end. Doing a pretty good job so far, but Ryan Gahuli, just a beast. I mean, especially in the ring here. Stared down Kelly before the bout even started.
You could see it. I think you guys at home could maybe see out of that left corner, bottom left corner, but Gahuli was literally standing still, staring directly at Colin Kelly. Colin Kelly with a little bit of movement, kind of maybe a little bit of nerves as he's a new transfer into Mount Carmel.
Bouncing around a bit, and I just saw Gahuli didn't move, just stared him down. A lot of grit coming from these guys tonight.
Now, if any of you guys remember last year, Ryan Gahuli fought, now graduated, last year was a senior, Joey Thompson, a football player. And my goodness, that was the most aggressive fight I've ever seen. These guys, boom, 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 right out the gate. Gahuli, a little different approach.
A lot more strategic tonight. You know, Gahuli was, I would say, an underdog last year, but, you know, this year it's definitely Colin Kelly. Here we go, back in the ring now. Gahuli backing off. Kelly is in the corner now. Nice body shots. Oh, could have been a big hit there. Missed that opportunity. Colin Kelly now trying to push him off, runs away a bit. Kelly walking him down.
Gahuli's able to maintain the center, but now he's kind of
losing
Kelly's kind of taking it.
Kelly is just throwing his hands at him. I mean, anything he can get. That right uppercut, right jab combo is working for him so far. He's using it to his advantage.
There's a nice right hook.
Here we go. Gahuli saving his energy. Getting some big hits in. Pushes him off. Now he's got him up against the ropes. Kelly puts his head down.
Lots of fatigue.
Big body hit to end off the second round there. Heading into the last round, I mean, Colin Kelly, he's aggressive, but he's throwing his hands out there trying to get any hit he can. Gahuli, a lot more, you know, keeping it in, wants to wait for those right moments where he can attack.
It looked like he had a great opportunity towards the end of that round to take some good shots at Kelly, kind of just standing against the ring, but obviously fatigue is playing a role.
Yeah.
As I said earlier, last year he came out as fast as can be, kind of lost a little bit of that energy as the fight went on, but this year, kind of the same.
Yeah.
I mean, he's obviously taking a more strategic approach, but that fatigue is still there.
I definitely like the way they stacked up these fights. You know, we go from Muha and Vinny Winters, huge aggressive fight, and then you move into a freshman and a junior, a lot more conservative, and now this fight's all about strategy. Colin Kelly's strategy, he just wants to be aggressive because he knows Gahuli is a great fighter.
Yes.
He's trying to get as many hits as he can. Gahuli, though, as you can see, a lot more defensive side tonight. Gahuli running him down here. Kelly able to get some nice left jabs in. But here's Gahuli's time. Going at him. He's got him up against the ropes. It's Ryan Gahuli. Backs him down into a corner. Nice right jab there. What a combo. Two right jabs in a row. And now Kelly is just gassed. Gahuli still has some gas left in the tank, trying to use it to back down Kelly into the ropes here, trying to push him off. Kelly still showing he's in it. A nice combo. That must have been about four hits in a row.
And Kelly's got a chance.
Kelly has a huge chance right here.
His corner's cheering him on.
Coach Letts cheering him on.
He's
got to go at it here. Colin Kelly might have this one, folks. A huge upset might be brewing. Colin Kelly getting him down here. Gahuli's still fighting back. Nice hit there. He's got to make some more connections if he wants to win this thing.
Kelly has it.
I mean, Gahuli looks gassed. Nice right jab, but losing his balance, losing his footwork. Kelly's just kind of pushing him off. These guys are tired. They need some water. They need a nap.
Whoa!
They're gassed. We're going to let Anantzar Luka take it away.
Woo! They keep doing that. I'm going to be scared to come in the ring myself. Zachariah Maribelli, New York, Hollywood. That's pretty nice, Zach. They pay you to take pictures of you. That's the racket to be in, I'll tell you. Now, let me remind you folks of something. In amateur boxing, even if you hit someone hard, it does not count any more than a jab. So sometimes people get confused. A hard puncher or just a jab. In amateur boxing, it all means the same. 1 point per hit. And it's got to be on target. Let's see what the judges have decided. That was a really good match, and we have a couple big hitters coming up. So don't leave yet. Wait till you see the super heavyweights. Woo! One of them is Tony DiFilippo standing right there. He's going to be
Now, Matt, I really think this fight could go either way.
Okay, sometimes these...
You know, you got Gahuli.
Bouts like this are
more experienced.
Very, very hard to judge.
More strategic. Kelly was just kind of throwing his hands, but he was still making those hits, getting some connections. So you're definitely right, though. This could definitely go either way. I would not be surprised at all, no matter who wins.
Yep.
Gahuli does seem a little more fatigued, a little more tired than Kelly does. Kelly was able to stay on his feet.
Give these guys
a
next round of applause.
We're going to let him take it away and see who the winner is.
But the judges have made their decision. And who do you think it is? In the right corner, Gahuli.
Well, more experience.
You know, thank you, folks,
landed a
for
lot
being
more
so kind.
Powerful jabs.
We're all
so.
Mount Carmel people.
We'll see what happens.
These kids are in class together. They're on the same football team together. And they, anyway, they're always in. Boxers enter the ring. Working out real good. It's only nine. The two big bouts are.
All right, Marty. Here we go. We have freshman Nick Reardon, a part of the volleyball team. He plays my position, so I get to see him every day at practice. And I got to tell you, there's always a smile on his face, even those days when he has to go to training for
anywhere,
boxing.
We're gonna,
always happy. Really excited to see how
really
he does.
We got a big crowd here tonight, so when you leave later, everybody be careful and leave me room downstairs where I can eat my sandwiches Because boy, oh boy, I'm really looking forward to it. In the blue corner.
Casilla.
He is a freshman at 150 pounds. His name is Isaac Castilla. And also 150 pounds, a freshman out of the red corner. His name is Nick Reardon.
Now, Matt, you were talking about Reardon being a friendly, smiley guy.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't think friendly, smiley guys are
Big
boxers, are they?
Yeah, I was, you know, I'm not going to lie. I was a bit surprised when he told me he was doing fight night because I don't really see him doing that. But I think he wanted to prove himself in the ring. He wanted to show what he was about.
Yep.
He does like boxing. I know that. So I'm really excited to see how he's going to be. He's going up against freshman Isaac Casilla. These guys both class of 26. Nick's got some great footwork.
Casilla kind of standing tall, backing off a little bit. Looks like Reardon's the aggressor right now.
Yeah. Kind of controlling that center of the ring. Seems to back off, though. Backing off into a corner. Looks like Casilla might have him. Able to back off. Nick Reardon goes in for a powerful jab right there. Both missing a lot of punches right here. I think it's going to be about, you know, who can stay on their feet the longest. If Reardon can land a nice jab to his head, it's going to be really impactful because these guys are going to be tired when these punches start to land. Casilla seems to, you know, jazzle up Nick there a bit. That's going to be the end of the first round. You know, Reardon definitely seemed to be the aggressor starting off this bout. But Isaac is still staying in it. Casilla doing a great job out there. Both of these guys' footwork is pretty good for being freshmen and all, so.
Yep. Noticing a lot of decent punches. Most of them are landing. And as Mr. DeLuca said, it's the punches that land that really count and affect your score and whether or not you'll win the bout.
All right, coming up, we've got the second round of this freshman bout. Fifth one since intermission. Just to recap, right after intermission, sophomore Ryan McCormick beat junior North Kulatunga. And then the next bout, sophomore Matt Muha beat junior Vinny Winters. And then Lucas Sertzis, the junior, beat Sandor Mosqueda, the freshman. And just previously, as you saw, probably the most even matchup we've seen tonight. Even though going into it, Gahuli, you know, probably had the upper hand. Colin Kelly, we didn't really know much about him, but he definitely proved himself today. He may have lost to Gahuli, but it was still a really great fight for him.
For sure. Couple glove smacks for Isaac over there in the blue corner. Let's see if he can bring the aggressiveness.
Ready to go, he's pumped up. Let's see what these guys got. Freshman. Bell rings. It's just pretty even, you know, a lot of misses. Nick Reardon backs off a bit here. He's in the red, wearing red in the brown quarter, excuse me. Casilla wearing blue in the white corner. His headgear falling up, moving up his chin a bit.
Reardon's getting some nice punches with that strong right arm.
Yeah, Casilla, yeah, he needs to fix that headgear right there. It's moving a lot, blocking his vision a bit. Reardon definitely the aggressor in this matchup.
It looks like Reardon's kind of using that left arm for defense and that right arm for all his power.
Yeah. He's kind of blocking that left jab coming from Casilla to then move in with his own right jab.
Yep.
See what he's got. Falling back a bit. Casilla lands a nice right jab. Casilla now moving a bit. He's got Reardon on the ropes. This round almost about to wrap up.
Slowing down a little bit.
These guys both look to be okay. A little time out here talking to his coach. Need to tie his shoe up.
Got to give a big thank you to Coach Later. Little mid-round shoe tie.
Yeah. That's the round.
Can I see it kind of almost backing away his head from dodging those punches?
Yeah.
Like, it's almost turning his whole body.
You know, it may be a little sloppy, but these guys, they both have their own strategies. You see Reardon using both hands, that left one for defense, right one for offense. Casilla is kind of moving around the ring, trying to slow down Reardon. So,
yep.
We have two freshmen fighting right now, but after this bout, we have two sophomores going at it. And then after that matchup, going to be even bigger. The super heavyweight bout, I mean, do I even have to say it? It's Asher, it's Eddie, Tomaszewski and Fleck going at it. Really excited for that one. Here we go, moving into the third round here of this all-freshman bout. I think Reardon has the upper hand so far.
Yep.
I definitely expect him to take the win, but you never know. Casilla could come out with a big jab here. Right now, just kind of throwing his hands, but his defense is pretty good. He's able to back off, make a couple of dodges just right there. Reardon moving in. Trying to make a connection. Reardon going high. Casilla trying low.
A lot of hooks coming from Reardon. Using that left arm to almost open up Isaac's face for a little punch.
Casilla backing down a bit. Reardon moving up. Casilla running away a bit. Bit of a standoff, center of the ring here. Casilla takes the first move in that standoff.
Nice punch from Isaac there. His coach is telling him it's go time.
Hyping him up. If he wants to win, it's right now. They've only got so much time left in this last round. Both fighters going at it. I gotta tell you, that gas tank is empty for these guys. They're gassed, they're exhausted, tired. Let's see who won in this all-freshman bout.
Okay. Now it's time. After the decision is made, stick around, folks. Here comes some big money raffle and these beautiful boxing gloves. The raffle is coming up in just a second. In fact, why don't you get up here and I'll show the gloves. Stay right. Okay, here we go. At 150 pounds, the judges have made their decision. Sometimes it's a tough one. Sometimes it's a split decision. I'm not supposed to tell you that. The winner is out of the red corner. Reardon.
Well, Marty, that all-freshman bout, Nick Reardon gonna take home the win. All-around great fight there. Now I think
these
we've got some
awards to give
away. These
boxing gloves are being raffled off. Just how beautiful they would be in anyone's den, hanging out somewhere. So, I think all the raffle tickets are gone for the boxing gloves, but they're going to pull the tickets right now before the big raffle. Yes. Okay, one ticket wins the boxing gloves.
Oh, okay, number 0 5 4 3 1 0.
Here, did you hear that? We'll do it again for these beautiful boxing gloves.
0 5 4 3 1 0.
Is there a winner? One more time. One more time. Here we go. We're good before we pull another number.
0 5 4 3 1 0.
Okay, we have a winner for the beautiful boxing gloves. Thank you. Thank you.
What are you laughing at?
I don't know. Okay, here we go. The president of Mount Carmel High School, Brendan Conroy, is going to start drawing some tickets. There's a lot of money involved here. Okay, they're going to pull all the numbers and then make the announcement later. How we doing on live streaming, Matt? Everything okay? Atta boy. Love it. I just got a text from somebody in Florida watching the fight, and think because of you guys, I got the text from Florida. How about that? They said the show's going great. Holy cow, how many winners are there? We got 10 winners. Four more to go. Something wrong?
I think you should help me. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give a hand to Clem DeLuca. Clem is the all-star of boxing announcers here. Thank you, Clem. You're the best. Let's also hear it for our referee, our judges, our coaches, and our student athletes. Let's give it up for those guys. Okay, we have some prizes here. We've got some raffle. Can you hold these, Tom? Thank you. 10th place prize, $200. Brian Schumacher. Brian Schumacher. Number 9. 9th place prize, $200, Tristan Lascu. I'm not sure if I'm saying that right, but Tristan Lascu. Eighth place prize, $200. Hal Slager. Eighth place prize, $200. Seventh place prize, also $200. Dawn Copeland and Cheryl Kwiatkowski. Sixth place prize, $200, goes to Jeannie Farnan. Now we're up to $500. $500 prize goes to John Sheehan. Fourth place for $500 goes to Jamie Black, $500. Third place is worth $1,000, goes to first initial N. Makuski. Second place prize is $2,000, $2,000, goes to Kelly Whalen. Congratulations, Kelly. And our first place prize winner, $7,000, goes to Nick Padilla, $7,000. Congratulations to all our cash winners. So we brought Tom up here, Tom Gliadek, because Tom sold over 200 raffle tickets. Let's give Tom a round of applause.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Tom. You're the best. Okay, be careful, all these old timers getting out of the ring. I'm calling them old timers. Okay, boxers, enter the ring. We have two more sensational bouts coming up. Thank you for all being a great audience tonight. At 175 pounds out of the blue corner, he's a freshman. His name is Lucas Ellis. And at 175 pounds, he is a sophomore. And his name is Leonard Siegel.
All right, here we are with the second to last bout of tonight's matchup, tonight's fight night. Here we go. We got Leonard Siegel in the red and Lucas Ellis in the blue.
Here we go. Leonard, big time boxer, lost last year, looking for a little revenge. Lost to another sophomore, Tim McInerney, who actually fought earlier tonight. Lucas Ellis has the height advantage, definitely that arm leg advantage. Here we go. Leonard is, he's angry. He fights, you know, he fights with aggression, fights with power. Big right hook right there.
Seen some very powerfulness.
I think Lucas
confidence.
Is talking to him right now. Might be some smack talk going on between these two sophomores, but yeah. What you were saying,
oh.
Marty. Falls a little back, loses his balance. Looks to be okay, though. I think they rung the bell. Yep. Little countdown here.
I mean, Leonard, really, that was pretty impressive. He
yeah.
came out very aggressive, landed some very good punches. As you know, Leonard is a wrestler for the Mount Carmel JV wrestling team. Very hardworking kid.
He does it all. He's, very, very smart kid. He's in the top three for our class, along with you and Christos Demas. Super smart. He actually came from South Korea a couple months before his freshman year, and he just fits right in. He's a Carmel kid at heart. We love having him here. And fight night is his night. He loves it. Last year, he had a bloody nose. I think there was a lot of blood on his face in his jersey. And he has a lot of pictures that he sent me of. There's just blood all over his jersey and his face.
Really?
And he's like, I loved it. I love the adrenaline rush I got. And I think that goes for every single fighter tonight. They love the nervousness. They
yeah.
love stepping into the ring because all that adrenaline going through them. They love this fight. Lucas Ellis, too. I mean, he loves it, too.
Got to see if you can capitalize after the end of that first round.
Kind of hitting each other at the same time here. Big
Siegel,
hook.
Nice
from
hook.
Leonard. I mean, textbook hook right there. Got him on the side of the head. Lucas going for some body shots here. He's got that arm. He's got the advantage for the arm length.
Noticing some very quick punches, jabs, and hooks. Just looking at Leonard
yeah.
Siegel on the red, these punches are powerful and they're
yeah.
quick.
It's all about speed for Leonard right here. But his feet, though, he gets them planted, and then he attacks. Stays on his toes, moving around the ring nicely. Lucas falling a back bit.
Nice move there from Leonard.
Leonard keeps going in. He likes that hook more than he does the jab. Lucas misses that hook right there. That's going to be the end of the second round. The adrenaline has kind of fizzled out. Still a really aggressive matchup. On Monday, May 1st, schools around the country will celebrate Principal's Day. We'd like to offer a special shout out to Mount Carmel's very own Mr. Scott Tabernacki.
His commitment to the caravan drives each of us to be better. We are very grateful for his leadership. Thank you, Mr. Tabernacki.
Thank you. Save the date and plan to join us for the Frank Kishka Memorial Golf Outing on Friday, July 14th at Cog Hill Golf and Country Club.
It's sure to be a great day with our alumni and friends out on the golf course. Now, those are pretty even first two rounds coming from these two sophomores, Lucas Ellis in the blue, Leonard Siegel in the red. Let's see if they can finish off this fight.
They got to finish strong. Like I said, the adrenaline has kind of run out. It's just pure strength right now. Whose skills are better? And I think right now it's Leonard. He's a lot more strategic in his moves. His defense is great. Hasn't lost any energy, it seems like. He's still going strong from the first round. Lucas still staying on his feet, though. He has that height advantage. It might get him the win late in this third round.
Fans are starting to cheer for the super heavyweight round. They can see the top left. You got Asher Tomaszewski and Eddie Fleck. These two big linemen ready to come for it.
Yeah.
We got Lucas Ellis, that bloody nose, bloody mouth.
Something's going on here. Last year it was Leonard with all the blood in his jersey. This year it's his opponent. Lucas coming out strong, but Leonard is stronger.
Lots of strong punches. These kids aren't messing around. This isn't sloppy.
Ooh, makes a connection with the right hook. Straight onto the nose. It's a bloody battle here for Lucas Ellis. Still staying strong in his feet at the center of the ring. Coming down to the last seconds here of the third round. Second to last bout of the night. These guys have got to give it their all, and that's the fight. What an exciting matchup between these two sophomores. Marty, in my opinion, I think Leonard Siegel took the win.
For sure.
But Lucas Ellis, still an incredible fight.
I gotta say that might have been one of my favorite rounds.
Oh yeah.
Tonight, just the aggressiveness of Leonard and Lucas.
Oh, brother.
Very strategic boxing there. We're gonna let announcer Clem DeLuca take it away before the super heavyweight bout.
Lucas Ellis' mouth is
all
bloody.
Over the ring.
Yeah, this doesn't look so great.
This is like the old days.
Hope he's all right.
Where's the doctor? Don't forget. Boy, what a battle. Give him a nice round of applause. Okay, here we go. The winner is out of the red corner, Leonard Segal. All right, before the super heavyweight step in the ring, I'm gonna clear out of the way. Now listen, anybody who wants to take a picture after we're done can come in the ring, keep it orderly, different positions. You could take a great picture here in the ring. So, thanks, Joey. Okay, we should get started. We're right on schedule. You'll be out of here at 9:45, unless you want to hang out with me downstairs eating sandwiches. Boxers, enter the ring.
Hey, Marty, are we going to stay late and eat some sandwiches with announcer Clem DeLuca?
You know, I'm debating my decision on that. Well, here we go.
This is what you have been waiting for. Saul Goodman has already pumped us up on Instagram, but now it's time for the real deal. Two seniors take their boxing skills to the ring. Asher Tomaszewski, committed to Kansas State, an incredible football program. He's wearing red in the brown corner.
Got some Asher chants going on. Eddie Fleck in the blue. We got to see if he can match him.
If I'm Fleck right now,
here we go.
I'm a little
super
nervous
heavyweight.
Because, you know, the crowd, they're chanting Asher's name.
Out I might blue feel corner.
Like, all right, you know, too much going
he
on right now. He's just got to focus on the ring.
80 pounds, whatever. He's a senior. His name is Eddie Fleck.
Let's go, Fleck.
I think they'll jump on him if he starts to get an upper hand.
Oh, yeah.
And here we go, another senior.
This is bound to
be
a fair fight.
He's out of the red corner, a super heavyweight. He is Asher Tomaszewski.
There we go. So everybody went to the student center, maybe to grab some food, grab some drinks. Everybody is in the alumni gym right now. I don't see anybody in the hallway. I don't see anybody outside. Everybody is right here chanting for the super heavyweights.
Got some Let's Go Zeus chants for Asher Tomaszewski.
Two football leaders, football captains, ready to go at it here. Starting off a little slow, center of the ring. Fleck lands a nice right hook, but Asher just goes right at him. Puts him on the ropes, some hits to the head. Headgear moves around a bit. You know, Marty, like you said before, will the friendship boat sail tonight? You know, it's one of those things, you get in the ring, you have to be aggressive, even if the guy's your friend.
Oh, I'm telling you, Asher forgot Fleck was his friend, I think, 4 hours ago.
Yeah. Here we go. Asher moving up on him. He had a nice jab earlier.
Got some Eddie chants going for Eddie Fleck in the blue.
Cheering on Fleck here. Now Asher, some Asher chants. Asher. Crowd going back and forth. I think the crowd is going to be pleased no matter who wins tonight. looks like Fleck got one last hit in. What a first round. Incredible job there by the super heavyweights. Congratulations to Mr. Dan LeCount and Mr. Craig Ferguson, who were inducted into the Chicago Catholic League Coaches Association Hall of Fame this past week.
Mr. LeCount and Mr. Ferguson have made incredible contributions to the Chicago Catholic League and have helped to inspire greatness in the many athletes that they have impacted through the years. Congratulations to you both on this well-deserved honor.
Mr. Ferguson, great hockey player here at Mount Carmel. Mr. LeCount, you know, he's been here for a while. He definitely helps me throughout the football and basketball seasons, giving me rosters, giving me stats. But now we're going to pull you guys back in here to this super heavyweight matchup. Crowd is a little divided. I hear some Asher chants. I hear some Fleck chants. They're going to touch gloves and start the second round.
I'm sure these guys have been told many, many times to control their fatigue, control their stamina.
I don't know if they're doing that right now. It's Asher. He's got Fleck on the ropes. Trying to move. At the
Asher's
center of the ring.
A lot.
No standoffs needed in the super heavyweight bout. These guys are just going at it. Fleck, ooh, almost falls down there, able to regain his balance. Asher sprinting across the ring, looking to get whatever hits he can on Fleck.
I think these guys are slipping in their gym shoes.
Yeah.
Or maybe it's that blood from Lucas Ellis earlier.
Could be, yeah. Ooh, Fleck takes a hit. It's a nice right hook by Asher. Gonna touch gloves here. Fleck moves in on him. Nice defense by Tomaszewski. Misses that right hook. Ooh, he falls to the ground.
Yeah.
Looks to be all right, though.
What a matchup. That doesn't get more exciting than this. It's two big 275-plus linemen, football players battling it out.
You know, I've heard some stories from my uncle, who's now the dean, Dan O'Connor. He said he would always wait until that last bout of the night because he knew it would be two of his best friends, because he was a lineman for the football team. So he said he knew it would be, you know, two of his lineman buddies just beating the crap out of each other in the ring. They would just go at it. And, you know, it's only 3 minutes, but it feels so much longer.
Mm-hmm. All right, before we enter this final bout, final round of our final bout, I want to give a couple of shout-outs. My first shout-out I want to give to my dad, Dan Mann. I know he's watching this in the garage, having some fun with his buddies, and I want to give another shout-out. First off, to the many people watching, even all the way in Naples, Florida, but to my cousin Jack Kelly watching at Rose Holman Institute, watching with his college roommates.
Yep.
Just goes to show how everyone loves the caravan.
Halfway across the country is still supporting us. Meeting up at the center of the ring now. Fleck moving in on him. Puts Asher to the ground. Bit of a shove there, though. There's no hit.
Fleck's dodging these punches from Asher.
See Coach Letts cheering up Fleck here. Ooh, Fleck falls into the ropes. Asher just keeps going at him. He's got him in the corner. It's Asher Tomaszewski. The ref gonna separate him here.
Looks like Asher's got the lead here. Fleck's gonna need, here goes.
Going at it here. Asher misses that hook. Fleck able to defend himself there. He was in the corner, but quickly got himself out of there, but now he might be caught up again. Asher pushes him into the ropes. They meet up at the center of the ring again. These guys are exhausted. It's the final bout.
It's
over. Ladies and gentlemen, Mount Carmel 2023.
We did it, 46 years. And it's complete. Thank you all. Remember, before you leave, Baracco's Pizza downstairs, they are just waiting for you to have a slice. Baracco's Pizza. Thank you all. Thank you all. What a great show tonight. You can come in the ring for photos. Remember to get your Baracko's pizza on the way home. Have a safe trip home, everybody. This has been a wonderful evening. And guess what? It's 9:45. Okay. The judges have made their decision. The winner is out of the red corner, Asher Tomaszewski.
Can you believe it? What just happened? Asher Tomaszewski takes down his best friend, Eddie Fleck, in the ring for Mount Carmel's 46th annual Fight Night.
Thank you, Dan LeCount. Thank you, all you guys live streaming. Thank you. It's been a great evening. Let's do it again next year.
Exactly.
Okay. Thank you, folks. You can come in the ring now and take pictures.
What a night, Matt Malloy.
Incredible. Here in the historic Alumni Gym, we mark another event in history. Beautiful night. These 13 bouts were incredible. Asher Tomaszewski takes the last win. His name is Marty Mann. My name is Matt Malloy. And good night, Chicago!
Turn it up a little bit higher. Turn up the radio. And I let her make me a song. Switch on your electric light. Then we can get down to what is really